Gentlemen, how do you find it here?
It will work for us. But our goal must be to scatter our operations. To live and work among the people we protect, just as Altairi Benla had once counseled.
Well, until that time, it's yours as you see fit.
Edward, Captain Woods Rogers survived his wounds. He has since returned to England, shamed and in great debt, but no less a threat.
I will finish that job when I return. You have my word. Evening, Anne.
Edward?
I'll be sailing for London in the next few months. I'd be a hopeful man if you were beside me.
England's the wrong way around the globe for an Irish woman.
Will you stay with the assassins?
No, I haven't got that kind of conviction in my heart. You?
In time, aye. My mind is settled and my blood is cooled.
Sail ho! Coming into the cove!
You're a good man, Edward. And if you learn to keep settled in one place for more than a week, you'll make a fine father, too. Of all the money that I had, I spent it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't. So felt me the parting glass. Good night and joy be with you. Sorry for my going away, and all the spirits where I've loved, they'd wish me one more day to stay. But since it falls unto my lot that I should rise, I'll gently and softly call. Good night and joy be with you all. Good night and joy be with you all.
Did you always know how to sail a boat?
The Jackdaw is a ship, Jenny. Not a boat.
But did you always know?
No. No, I learned after leaving Bristol.
After you left Mother?
Well, I didn't leave your... I didn't leave without saying goodbye, that is. It was an arrangement, you see, between your mother and me.
She said you left her. She said you always talked about sailing a boat. And making money in the new world.
I did always want to sail a ship. That's true. But not for a lark. To support us. To take care of her. And you.
Not me. Mother said you didn't know about me. She said you wrote only once a year, and that she never knew where to find you.
That's all true, and I'm sorry for that. I'd known earlier. I might have come home. I hope that I would have.
Well, you were busy. That's what I think.
I was, but that wouldn't have mattered.
Can I steal your boat?
Boat? I see no boat here. Do you?
Oh, I mean ship, obviously. I don't see the difference anyway.
Ah, it's a very simple one, Jenny. A ship can carry a boat, but a boat cannot carry a ship.
Why then, everything is a ship, large and small. But for my toy boat, the one I take into the bath with me.
That's a clever way of seeing it. Is it hard to talk about Caroline, Jenny? About your mother?
No. She passed some years ago. I miss her, but it's all right.
Was she in pain?
I don't know. I don't think so. She was very happy for quite some time. Then, not so happy. I didn't see her much after that. Then, she was gone.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I wasn't there for you.
It's all right. You're here now. And we're on an adventure.
Only a little one, I hope. I can't handle too many more surprises.
Do you think we'll see a whale?
Yes, there's a very good chance.
And what about pirates? Will I see pirates?
No. Not much chance of that, I think.
Oh, that's rather sad. I should have liked to have seen one.
Tell you what, Jenny. As soon as these winds die a little, I'll let you steer the jackdaw. One little trick at the helm before sundown.
Yay!
Miss Jennifer Kenway, may I introduce myself?
Jennifer Scott, if you please.
I'm sorry,
My daughter was raised by her mother, Caroline, until she passed away some years ago. Jenny prefers to use her surname to mine.
Ah, please forgive my ignorance.
I will. She may not.
Father, help me.
This little rascal, however, is a Kenway. What's wrong, Haven?
I can't see the stage.
Up we go. How's that?
Fine. But won't your arms tire?
Hey, I'm not so old as that. But if they do, then we shall quit this posh gig and go and meet your mother for some chocolate at White's. How's that sound?
Yes, please.
Okay, hush now.
Thank you. Initial reports on Aveline de Grand Prix led us to believe she would be too controversial and impulsive to appeal to a wide audience. Teenaged memories show her brainwashed and trained to kill political foes of her highly unstable mentor, Agate. Additionally, Aveline spent a disappointing amount of time in the Louisiana Bayou, consorting with smugglers of the lowest kind.
Oh, I try never to think.
Which we felt risked her appeal to our female audience, which is now approaching 50%. However, as Aveline matured, a new side emerged. A well-mannered and considerate lady of poise and compassion, Aveline came to embrace a new mentor, her stepmother, Madeline de Lisle, a tireless fighter for the rights of slaves.
Thank you, Madeleine.
With some editing to prioritize this relationship, we feel Aveline's story will more than meet our needs. Our team recommends a go on this property. Get this one to market quickly.